Hey everyone, today I am going to gap a ring for a new cylinder that I'm putting on my Maxi. If the gap on the ring is too small, when the piston ring gets hot, it'll expand and it'll bulge out into one of your ports and snag. If the gap is too large, you'll get a lot of blow by, which is when the gases squeeze past the ring instead of pushing the piston down. To gap your ring, all you need are feeler gauges and a file. To determine the piston ring gap, you want to multiply the diameter of the cylinder by 0.004 millimeters. For this Pollini, that comes out to about 0.18 millimeters. So that's what I'm going to gap this ring to. That will allow it to expand and not snag a ring, but it also won't be too large that I get a lot of blow by. To measure the gap, we have to insert the ring into the cylinder and slide it down about half an inch using the piston to square it up. Okay. Then use your feeler gauge and see what the gap is. My end goal is 0.18 millimeters, so I'm going to start a little bit below that at 0.13 and see if it's that big. 0.13 fits in quite loosely, so it's a little bit bigger than that. The next size up is 0.15. That also fits the gap. 0.18 doesn't quite fit, so I need to make the piston ring gap just a little bit bigger to fit 0.18. I like to put a file in the vise and then do one side at a time. So first this side, do a little bit, and then the other side. And you want to make sure it's really flat. Clean up the edges a little bit so there's no burrs. And then we're going to check it again. Put it in and slide it about half an inch down. And I'm going to check it with the 0.18 millimeters. And that fits perfect. So that's how you gap a ring. Now just make sure to clean up the edges so there's no burrs and you're good to go. Once you have your gap properly set, you can put the piston ring on your piston. Start at one end and slowly work it around. Alright, now it's time to put the engine together. Now that this piston ring is gapped, I'm ready to put the rest of the engine together.